Welcome to One Chemistry. This is 1 minute chemistry series. We are going to quickly see Jahn Teller effect. We will see the reason with Z in, Z out situation. What is Jahn Teller effect? It is also called Jahn Teller distortion. Normally it's a geometrical change. It's a change in shape. The distortion occurs. This happens to create the dissymmetry or to decrease the energy there. The distortion happens in the Z axis in the octahedral system. The distortion may be the ligands on the Z axis can go above or below, or you can say inside or outside. So moving up Z ligands create the distortion. Here when the Jahn Teller effect will come, the asymmetrical distribution of electron in the octahedral splitting will come. This may happen in the low spin and high spin situation. Here given all possible situation. You just see D3 and D5 system which is in high spin don't have any effect. Similarly D10 also don't have any effect. So the electron has to be asymmetrically filled for Jahn Teller effect. When the Jahn Teller effect will be strong or weak, when the electron asymmetrically filled in the EG orbital, the effect will be maximum or it is strong. The reason is the Z in, Z out happen in the axis which is in the D square space. So maximum distortion occur in the EG distribution. Then the important fact, Z in and Z out. Z in mean the Z ligand going outside, it is called tetragonal expansion. In that case, axial bonds are longer than the equatorial bond. The important fact, similarly in the Z in case, bond length of axial will be lesser than the equatorial. This is called tetragonal compression because L ligand moving inside. When the Z in and Z out will come, normally you have to calculate from CFSE, Z in and Z out, you have to do the splitting. Z in mean Z orbital going higher energy, Z out mean Z orbital going below energy. If you fill the electron, you can roughly calculate the CFSE. Here I given D1 electron situation. The Z in will be more stable because it has 2 by 3 delta value. The same electron in Z out will have higher value. So low energy than Z out. So the most stable is Z in. This is not hard to memorize. Here just see configuration and distortion. The Z in and Z out not hard to memorize. It is easy. You have to just memorize Z in, Z out and know. The D1, D2, D3, D4 you have to write consecutively. Similarly D6, D7, D8 to T10. The D1 and D6 are Z in, D2 and D7 are Z out. D3 and D8 don't have distortion. If you have D4 it's Z in, D9 is Z out. That is the important thing, you should not confuse it up. Then D5, D10 obviously don't have any distortion. So memorize Z in and Z out and know. That's all from this video. Thanks for watching.